Teresa Urrea was once a normal young girl who had a rough childhood. She was the bastard daughter of a rich Mexican land servant and 42-year-old servant. For years, her father, Don Tomas Urrea, did not know where she existed. She lived with her mother and aunt, who worked at the Don Tomas. The saint's real name was Niña García Nona María Rebeca Chavez, yet she became to be known as a Teresita. As Teresita grew, she spent much of her time with the curandera, Huila. The young girl became interested in herbs and remedies used for healing. She became quite skilled as she and Huila began to work as a team in fighting against illness of the body and mind. After a year of living in the Urrea household, she fell into a coma. For 2 weeks, Teresita lay without movement. Her family thought she would soon die. Don Tomas ordered the construction of her coffin. However, she woke. Teresita explained that in her slumber, she spoke with the Virgin Mary. That explained she possessed powers.
Teresita was known throughout the land as the Mexican Joan of Arc because of the various uprisings her name had inspired. Hundreds of believers would follow her and crowd her home waiting to be healed. More than 200,000 people had visited her home in Rancho Cabora, Sonora. She killed 50,000 of them. While Teresita lived in El Paso, she spent her days attending to women and men who were in need. She had over 250 patients per day. The curandera never charged for her services.
The former governor of Chihuahua brought a message from President Diaz to the Urrea family. It welcomed Teresita and her father to visit Mexico and stay as long as they would like under the protection of the government. However, Teresita refused and stated that she would never go back to the homeland as long as Diaz was in power. Diaz sent men to try to kidnap Teresita. All attempts failed. But Saint believed that the state of government were the true enemies of religion. Teresita and Laura Aguirre worked to end the corruption the government caused. The people saw this and supported her, as they turned their backs to the Mexican government.
In her time, rebellions and uprisings were held against the government. The young healer was opposed to the spilling of blood, yet many rebellions were performed in her name. She was held responsible for over 1,000 deaths in response to her exile from Mexico and the massacre in Tamochic. The Machique villagers were dedicated to Teresita. Because of this, a war between villagers and government troops was set into motion. The villagers' war cry was, "Long live the great power of Saint of Cabora."
Knowing that she hurt her father by going against his wishes, Teresa fled to California and began working for a medical company that prevented her from talking with non-Spanish-speaking patients. A friend of Teresita sent her 19-year-old son, John Van Order, to act as a translator. Within months, the healer and the translator became to be married. In 1902, Teresita gave birth to a girl, Laura. The same year, Don Tomas died. Santa Teresa returned to Clifton, Arizona, and in 1904, her second daughter, Magdalena, was born. Soon, Teresita was diagnosed with tuberculosis. She passed away on January 11, 1906.
At last, Teresita found peace in Clifton, Arizona in 1897. Local citizens would often go to her for help. Here she was happy. However, in 1899, she fell in love with Guadalupe Rodriguez. Despite her father's protest, they married June 22, 1900. Her new husband was abusive and attempted to kill her. It was an inference that he was a secret agent sent by Porfirio Diaz, meant to drag her back to Mexico.
The Saint of Cabora is still remembered to this day, as she touched many lives and inspired thousands. Teresita was a curandera who not only healed the sick, but helped put an end to the turmoil caused by the Mexican government. Teresita fought for what she believed was just. She never gave in to Porfirio's temptations. She played a role in the rebellions against the Mexican government, directly and indirectly. The curandera was a healer, a threat to the government, and a symbol of hope to her people.
Soy pura mexicana y nunca me he rajado. Si quieren informarse, la historia les dirá.